In a letter authored by the President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni to the Prime Minister Robinah Nabbanja on April 3, 2023, regarding the iron sheet scandal, the President directed that all ministers who took iron sheets for personal use be handed to police for criminal prosecution, saying what they did was theft. The President also promises to take political action once the police concludes their investigations into the matter. In the letter, the President directed all ministers who are consciously involved in the scandal to take personal responsibility and pay back the value of the iron sheets they diverted. The move has been welcomed by members of Parliament.
On the issue of iron sheets, to the effect that the ministers who received them should return them or pay money equivalent to the iron sheets they took. Well, first of all, I don't know the source of information, but if that is true, then it is okay. Let them refund the iron sheets that were taken, whether it is from Karamoja or from any other docket under the OPM, so that it is really given formally in the right way.
However, some legislators are concerned that the President's directive may interfere with the ongoing court proceedings and investigations by police as it makes some conclusions on the matter.
We don't want the President to become the judge and the jury. He's the one that told the police to investigate, let the police do the investigation, take it to the state attorney, let the state attorney or the DPP come up with the sanctions or sanction the files in a way or exonerate the people and let's see them serve their sentences.
So, it is himself. Of course, they are going to take back the money, they are going to take back the iron sheets. But that does not even kill the case. When you are caught in the possession of the recently stolen property, it is an offense. Even if it has been found in your possession, it is an offense. And you must be convicted and sentenced accordingly.
Relatedly, a section of members of parliament have come out to fault the Presidential Affairs Committee, which is investigating the iron sheet scandal, for interrogating the implicated top government officials in the comfort of their offices instead of the committee rooms. The committee interfaced with the government chief whip Dennis Oboa, third deputy prime minister Rukia Nakadama, the prime minister Robinah Nabbanja and the vice president Jessica Alupo from their respective offices.
The committee, the time I've been in the parliament of Uganda as a legislator, it's only the president who have special treatment, but no any other person. So the committee blundered. After convening meetings at parliament, and then you go and have a meeting in somebody's office, that was erroneous. It is out of the law, it's ridiculous. I condemn it, that in the future, as committee of parliament, we must work according to the rules of procedure.
I'm surprised some of the meetings are taking place outside. Maybe it is on the request of people who are being met. Maybe they have other challenges that cannot allow them walk to parliament.
So whatever they are doing and whatever report they are getting from whoever's office is a wrong report. We want them to come here and repeat their activity. Let them bring the prime minister here. We are ready to go there. There are some pertinent questions that we want to ask the prime minister beyond even the Mabati. Yeah? So beyond the iron sheets, there are very many other pertinent things that have gotten lost in prime minister's office, to include cash, that we need to ask the prime minister when she comes here. The vice president, there are very many things that we want to ask her, and we are immune when we are here. We can say anything. From here, we can even institute an investigation against her, and her police cannot do anything, because we are in control. But when we are in her premises, she's in control.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.